My name is Chang Teresa, the founder of the English method called English Tree. Throughout 9 years of teaching English to a variety of students from many countries all over the world, I have come to realize one thing, that studying English is pretty much the same with planting a tree. Isn't it amazing? In today's video, I will tell you why is that the same and 4 steps to master this method. Step 1, sow the seed. What is the seed of a language? Imagine you are speaking to a foreigner. You are speaking sentence by sentence by sentence. So sentences come from phrases. Phrases come from words, and words come from sounds. In English, there are 44 sounds that you need to master. Mastering these 44 sounds or learning pronunciation will help you or allow you to be able to hear and recognize about 1 billion words in English. Isn't it incredible? But anyway, pronunciation and listening have to go hand in hand. Good pronunciation helps your listening skill and vice versa. Listening skill helps pronunciation. Let's move on to step 2, deepen the root. Once the seed breaks the shell and grows, it will develop into a whole root system. Not just one single root, but the whole system. And it's just like how grammar works. There are about 30 grammar points in English, both basic and advanced grammar. But in this case, just only focus on basic grammar first. And so they work together and combine and connect with one another into a whole grammar system. Basic grammar includes noun phrases, verb phrases, adjective phrases, just like here, noun, verb, adjective. Also learn tenses and the traditional type of sentence structure, subject, verb, object. Because you learn noun, verb, adjective, which are the function words to make up a sentence, then remember to also learn a basic vocabulary, 9 to 10 basic topics in your life that you have to use every day in your conversation with a foreign speaker. Let's say environment, shopping, eating, food, clothes, grocery, restaurant, travel, tourism, anything that relates to your life. The firmer your grammar gets, the firmer and more solid your root will get into a solid trunk of tree. So in this case, remember, only focus on one thing at a time. Step 3, spread the branches. Once you have a firm and solid foundation, now is the chance for the trunk to develop into different branches. Imagine each branch is like one further topic you want to learn. Let's say finance, economics, politics, culture, religion, tourism, traveling, education, sport, any of them. And the vocabulary is like one leaf. So the more vocabulary and special terms you get, add them into each topic like this. It helps you to speak about 1 million sentences and expressions, your ideas in English. Now, the further and higher the range reaches to the sky, the deeper and greater the vocabularies are. So that's all about step 3, spread the range. Remember, in this stage, don't try to overwhelm yourself with too advanced and complicated grammar. Remember to reuse the grammar you have learned from step 2. Only increase your vocabularies. Step 4, bloom your flowers. Continue the development of the branches. When the time comes, the season comes, when you are ready, now is the time to bloom your flowers. Imagine you're speaking to a foreigner. They can easily recognize how good your English is. Just like when they look at the flowers, they know how good and how great your tree is, right? So the new focus of this step is speaking. Let's add more of the advanced grammar, but keep the same amount of vocabularies you have learned from the last step. So I recommend you to use mind maps. See the network of all the branches? They are just like mind maps. But you know, there is a problem that I bet that almost all students have to face when they learn English. Step 1, 2, 3, we seem to just learn with textbook English. But remember, when you open a textbook or a handout, the knowledge, the vocabulary, and the information is already outdated. You need something updated, something brand new, something that you see every day. In this step, also one more focus you should add into your learning is the new sources of study. Newspapers, talk shows, reality shows, everything that is real, because now is the time for your English to get real. Now, do you wonder what is the ultimate product of the tree? That's not flowers, right? That is fruits. But why is not here? Well, I think that fruits are like the mark that you get in any exam, like IELTS, TOEFL, or TOEIC. Well, the better your mark is, just like how sweet it is for your fruits. I don't add it here because it will be the natural product. It comes when the flowers in season. So I hope that after these four steps, you can make a decision whether you just continue to speak it in your job, in your daily life, or you continue or choose one exam that you want to take part in. Okay, let's review our four steps. Step one, sow the seed. The focus are pronunciation and listening. Step two, deepen the roots. The focus are grammar and vocabulary. Remember, just basic grammar and basic vocabulary. Step three, spread the branches. The focus now is more vocabulary, special terms depending and belonging to the topic. And step four, the focus is speaking, speaking, and speaking. And the sources are real English.